sequence Why Anything But with Kumar de Silva at the beautiful Galadari Hotel. The show sponsored by LICC Jeans, and my guest is Chulpadmendra Kumarapathirana. Chula, you were Miss Sri Lanka in 2006. Supermodel, hot model, sexy model, bomb model, all that. Do you miss that life?
Well, not really. Still, you know, I miss those shows at that time. They used to have very, you know, much, the standard-wise, even for models, were much higher than today.
Why do you say that?
I think more creative people were doing shows that time, okay, and more talented, more sophisticated models were working with us that time. Unfortunately, it's very hard to find nowadays.
Who was Chula the model? What was she? Who was she? And what did she, you were right there. What did you have to hit it right up there?
Well, I think my passion, you know, I work hard, even the body-wise, you know, like, you know, I always want to hit internationally. That's why during tsunami time, we didn't have any shows in Sri Lanka. So then I went to England and I got two agents in London and I worked with them, did photo shoots.
You spoke of your body. How important is your body?
Body, I always say for a model, that is your office, that is your laptop, that is your everything for a model, you know, because...
Face?
Of course, face, definitely face. But especially for runway, you know, your body is very, because you go live. Nowadays with pictures, you can always Photoshop it and all. But when you're performing for a live audience, your body is, you know, they can see every fat, every stretch mark, everything you can see. So it's very important to maintain your body. And you are like a hanger, especially for designers. And I think designers loved me. I think I was very lucky to work with so many talented designers.
Who was the first one you modeled for? The very
Purnima Beratna. Okay. Yeah, I was very, I think I was very fortunate to work with such a talented designer. And I modeled for Mirror magazine. That time it was like Sri Lankan Vogue.
Yes.
It was very difficult to get a cover photo. And it was a cover picture I modeled. So I think my stepping stone was very good.
You said that your body was like a clothes hanger. So you said that clothes used your body.
No, I think any model, you know, we give more value to the product. It can be a garment or a handbag, shoes, whatever. So I think if you, you know, it's not only body, means like head to toe, you know that. It's from nails, hair, everything should be in place.
What about nudity? How much of your body do you think you can show?
It depends.
See, as a model, you have swimwear, you have beachwear, you have underwear. Then what about you? Because now I can't do this, I can't do that. How does it work?
So if you're comfortable and if you have a good body and if that designer wants to use you, it's okay. But if you're not comfortable, you know, I will always...
Were you comfortable?
I was very comfortable, yeah. I was, you know, because if I go to the beach, I'll be wearing a swimsuit, or if I go to the pool and...
So basically you would cover about 90% of your body.
Yeah, yeah.
Beachwear, for
beach
example.
Beachwear, yeah, definitely.
Skimpy beachwear, small beachwear.
Yeah, I have done it. But I have never done any nude pictures, but I always...
That was my next question.
Yeah, okay.
Nothing nude, okay.
Nothing nude,
okay.
No.
Okay. So does a model... Funny question. Does one need to sleep with, I don't know, ABC to go up there?
No way. No.
Were you asked? Well, you did not, but were you asked? Were you approached?
Not in the fashion industry, but when it's come to movie and teledramas, yes.
Oh no.
Unfortunately. But I was, you know, but they didn't approach me direct, but I knew what they were looking for.
Butting, pitting, goading.
So because of that, I was cut out from those roles, but it doesn't matter, you know. So, like, you know, I didn't want, if I'm talented, I'll get hired. That's what I always say to my students. You will miss one or two shows, but in the future, you will get 10 more good shows that people who will hire you for your real talent. That's what matters, I think. And our conscience, you know.
Yes.
When you know you have reached there doing something, you have taken someone talented person's place.
Right, yes.
So...
As a Miss Sri Lanka, see, we, as I saw, we have hundreds of Miss Sri Lankas in Sri Lanka every month. But very few are remembered. Very, very few are remembered. And you are one of them. What did you have? What did Chula have to become the Miss Sri Lanka in 2006?
Well, I think we maintained, and it was only few pageants were happening that time, and with quality. And like, you know, when we save enough to date...
You're stressing the word quality, no?
Yes.
I noticed that, yes.
Yes, because it's hardly you can find. And those days, it's when you say Miss Sri Lanka, you had like... There's a huge responsibility. You're representing your country. You're an ambassador.
Exactly.
You're going to represent the whole of, you know, Sri Lankans in that platform. I mean, international platform. You should be able to answer the press and, with, you know, get on with the other contestants. You have to bring... So I think I did that well, and even when it's come to fashion industry, I have worked with international designers, like Czech. I have done a whole summer campaign in Czech for a designer called Bertha Rajaska. So that's what matters. I think that's why people remember me.
Chula, you see, as a model, and you were an adventurous model. Guys come after you. Uncles come after you. Openly they come, butting pitting they
Mallis.
Come. Mallis. Sorry, I forgot Mallis. Mallis come. How do you handle these uncles and ayahs and Mallis?
Well, to be
and
honest.
Some are very open about it.
Yeah, they're very open, you know. Like, I quite like the ones who are open than just trying to, you know, come butting pitting.
Okay.
Because it's okay, you're a human and you're a model, whatever. Sometimes you have attractions. I like some male models, not in Sri Lanka, but internationally. So it's okay, you know, that's a human thing that you will lassana devalte adila yanawa.
So when you say no, has it got, you know, sour, have they got nasty, have they got, you know,
some yes.
Okay.
Yeah, because sometimes they don't like to, they won't able to handle the rejection, so they get a bit upset, and you know, then after that I hear that they are saying nasty things about me. That's a typical Sri Lankan thing.
So back again to this, jatika kreeda.
Yeah, jatika kreeda.
Right, okay. Chula, you as a woman who's been through a lot of ups and downs both in your life, as you told me, what advice do you have for any young woman out there who wants to make it big, who wants to be a star, a singer, a film star, a model, an actress in Sri Lanka? What do you say?
The main thing is I should tell them there's no shortcuts.
Ah, okay.
You have to work hard for what you want, you know, because you can get shortcuts, but it's very temperamental. I'm sure in your, that.
Yes.
And, you know, work towards your goal. I know there'll be like things, you know, happening, but don't forget, you know, every time work to your goal, you know what you want in life, and work and be independent. It doesn't matter whether you're 60, 50.
Independent, okay, okay.
Like, you know.
That's what you are.
Yes.
You love your independence, you love your freedom.
I love my freedom. I think that's, you can't put a price tag for that. That's one of the things I think nobody should really. Put a price tag and get.
So Chula has no price tag on her freedom. Thank you very much for being my guest on the show. End of sequence. Why? We now talk to Chula in next all about her academy, or her modeling academy, and how she trains and molds models. So a quick costume change. Back to the show. This is Anything But Kumar de Silva, sponsored by LICC Jeans and at the beautiful Galadari Hotel, the businessman's home in Colombo. Catch you soon.